可以开始，我喷嚏吗？这个，
嗯，可以了。
Om Jnana Tamarandasya Gananjana Shalataya Chaturun Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vanchakalpatarubhyascha Kripasindhu Bhayevata Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Adwaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're reading chapter 81 of the Krishna book entitled The Brahman Sudama, Blessed by Lord Krishna.
我们今天来读 Krishna 快乐全员第八十一章，标题是祝 Krishna 赐福 Sudama Brahman。
So we heard how Sudama Brahmana had gone to Dwarka and he'd met with Lord Krishna。
我们听说 Sudama Brahmana 是如何去了 Dwarka， 又在那里遇见了主 Krishna。
And we heard how Lord Krishna evenTook some of the dry rice that Sudama had brought with him.
We heard that Lord Krishna even ate some of Sudama Brahma brought with him.
So they enjoyed talking together, remembering their childhood in the Gurukula of Sandipani Muni.
They were together.重叙旧事，回忆起他们在三地帕尼穆尼的学校里上学的时光。
And the next morning, Sudama left to go back home.
等到次日早晨 ，Sudama Brahmana 就启程回家了。
He never asked Lord Krishna for anything.
他从来没有向主 Krishna 要求任何东西。
And he felt.Very satisfied just to have been with Lord Krishna.
仅仅是和主 Krishna 在一起，他已经心满意足了。
He considered himself to be so fortunate. Lord Krishna had embraced him with his two arms. Usually, Lord Krishna would only embrace the goddess of fortune.
他感到自己幸运之极。他感到自己非常幸运，因为主 Krishna 用双臂甚至拥抱了他。通常 Krishna 只拥抱幸运女神。
And Sudama had sat on the bed where the goddess of fortune lays to take rest.
Sudama Brahmana 甚至他坐在了幸运女神平常睡觉的床上。
And the goddess of fortune had taken the chamara and used it to refresh Sudama Brahmana.
幸运女神手持拂尘，为 Sudama Brahmana 扇凉。
So in this way, Sudama was remembering all the loving dealings which took place between him and Lord Krishna and Lord Krishna's wife.
就这样 ，Sudama Brahmana 回忆着。他和主 Krishna 以及主 Krishna 的妻子之间的交往。
And he thought that Lord Krishna had been very kind to him by not giving him anything.
他认为主 Krishna 太仁慈了，主 Krishna 没有赐予他任何事物。
And Sudama thought that Krishna knows I'm very poor, and if I get some money, I might become puffed up and proud.And mad after opulence and forget Krishna.
他认为主 Krishna 知道他非常穷，一旦他得到了钱财，就会变得骄傲，变得傲慢，并为此的富裕感到疯狂，从而忘记了 Krishna.
So that would be the most inauspicious thing which could happen if Sudama forgot Krishna.
倘若苏达玛遗忘了 Krishna， 这将是最不吉祥的事情。
But he was remembering how Krishna had practically worshipped him. He offered arti and he washed his feet and then he massaged his feet.
Sudama Brahma 还回忆着, Krishna 甚至崇拜了他, 他给他供奉 arti, 灯仪, 甚至为他按摩他的足。
And then he fed Sudama with his own hand.
并且亲手给苏达玛食物吃。
So everything which Sudama was thinking is actually true, that if somebody gets wealth, then it's very common that they forget about Krishna.
Sudama他这些想法都是真实的，因为倘若一旦人有了财富的话，他们就会，普通人就会遗忘Krishna.
If an ordinary man is very poor and prays to the Lord to get some benediction, material opulence, then if he gets what he wants and he becomes rich, then he'll forget Krishna.
普通人因为贫穷向主祈求赐予物质富裕，但以某种方式发迹后。
He forgets that the wealth which he got was given to him by the grace of Krishna. So Krishna doesn't give that kind of opulence to his devotee unless the devotee is very faithful and very strong in Krishna consciousness.
主通常是不会赐予这样的物质富裕的，除非这样的人他是十分的有信心，在 Krishna之觉中非常坚定强大。So
if a neophyte devotee serves Krishna very, very nicely, very sincerely, and at the same time, if they want material opulence, then Krishna will not allow him to get that.
倘若一位新的奉献者很好的、非常真诚的服务了 Krishna， 同时也希望得到物质的富裕，主便会使他得不到物质富裕。
In this way, the devotee is protected from forgetting Krishna.
这位奉献者便
So Sudama was thinking like this, and gradually he came to his own home.
Sudama Brahmana 想着这一切，不知不觉的已经回到了家中.
But when he got to his own home, he saw that everything was all changed. It was all different.
但他一到门前。 就发觉一切都已经改变了。
Previously, the place where he lived, there was just a small cottage, but now there were big palaces made of valuable stones and jewels.
之前他们住的是一所小茅屋，现在已经变成了宏伟的宫殿，并且以珍贵的宝石而建成。
And these places were effulgent, they were glittering like the sun and the moon.
这所宏伟的宫殿闪耀着如日月一般的光华。
So not only were there big palaces, but there were also beautifully decorated parks.
一所宏伟的宫殿，还看见了美丽的花园。
And in the parks there were many good-looking men and women strolling in the park.
在花园中有俊美的男人女人在那里散步。
And in the parks there were lakes which were full with lotus flowers and different beautiful lily flowers, and there were even flocks of different colors of birds.
在这所漂亮的公园里，还有着一个湖泊，湖泊上有盛开的莲花与百合，有七彩的鸟群游曳其间。
So when Sudama saw how the whole place had been converted, he began to think to himself what had happened.
当 Sudama Brahmana 看到眼前这一切的转变时，便开始自问到这到底是怎么样的一回事呢？
He said, how am I seeing all these changes?
这里难道是属于我的吗？
Does this place really belong to me, or does it belong to somebody else?
这个地方是属于我还是属于别人的呢？
If it's the same place where I used to live, then how has it changed in such a wonderful way?
如果这是以前我所居住的地方，为什么变得这样美妙呢？
So while the Brahmana was thinking like this, a group of beautiful, good-looking men and women, they approached him.
Sudama Brahmana 就这样想着的时候，一群俊美的男女就开始迎接他。
These people looked like they were demigods.And they were accompanied with different musical chanters, people playing musical instruments.
这群人看上去就像半神一样，而且是在音乐的伴奏之下。
So they approached Sudama to welcome him.
他们上前来欢迎 Sudama.
All of them were singing different.They were singing auspicious songs.
他们口里都齐唱着吉祥的歌曲。
And Sudama's wife was very happy on hearing about her husband's arrival, that he'd come back.
Sudama 的妻子听到丈夫回来，心中非常欢喜。
And when she heard that Sudama had come, she came running out of the palace to greet her husband.
当她听说 Sudama 回来之后，连忙奔出宫殿去迎接他。
And when Sudama saw his wife, it seemed like as if the goddess of fortune had come to receive him.
当 Sudama 看见自己的妻子的时候，就好像是幸运女神亲自来迎接她一样。
Now she was so beautiful. Before she had been very thin and weak, but now she came and she was dressed before in rags. But now she was so beautiful. She was so attractive.
她的妻子以前是，瘦弱，非常瘦弱又虚弱的。那她穿的衣服也都是衣衫褴褛的样子，可是她现在看上去如此的靓丽，有吸引力。
So when as soon as she saw her husband before her, tears came into her eyes and she began to cry.
她一看到自己的丈夫，便不禁高兴地流下泪。
And her voice choked up; she could not even speak to her husband.
她声音哽塞，甚至无法开口对自己的丈夫讲话。
She just closed her eyes in ecstasy.
她只是在狂喜当中闭上了双眼。
But with great love and affection, she bowed down before her husband.
她深情款款的，满怀爱意的顶拜了自己的丈夫。
And then, within her heart, she thought of embracing him.
她在心中想象着拥抱自己的丈夫。
She appeared in front of him, fully decorated with a gold necklace and ornaments.
他颈上戴着金项链与饰物。
And it appeared like she was like a demigod's wife who just came from an airplane from the heavenly planets.
她看上去就像半神的妻子刚刚从飞机上下来。
The Brahmana was surprised to see his wife so attractive and beautiful.
这位婆罗门看到自己的妻子这样有魅力，这样漂亮，他感到异常的惊讶。
So Sudama didn't say anything. He just walked into the palace with her.
Sudama 一言不发，深情款款地与妻子一起进入了宫殿。
So when the Brahmana entered into his personal apartment in the palace, he saw that he thought it was not just an apartment, but it was the residence of the King of Heaven.
Sudama Brahman 一进入自己的房间，便发觉那儿不仅仅只是一所房间，简直就是天地应者的寝宫。
And the palace was surrounded by many columns of jewels.
宫殿里有许多华丽的柱子，上面点缀着珠宝。
And everywhere there were couches and bedsteads made of ivory and covered with gold and jewels.
到处都有像牛奶般雪白的床垫，柔软，有点缀着黄金珠宝。
And the beddings were covered with sheets as white as milk and as soft as a lotus.
那里的床榻是用象牙做成，床垫牛奶般雪白，莲花般柔软。
And there were many whisks hanging from golden rods.
金柄的浮尘飘扬着。
And there were golden thrones with sitting cushions as soft as lotus flowers. On the throne, there were these cushions which were as soft as lotus flowers.
黄金宝座上的坐垫柔软的像莲花。
And in different places, there was velvet and silk canopies with laces of pearls hanging.
天鹅绒和丝质的斗篷以珍珠绣边儿。
And the whole building was constructed on an excellent, it was all constructed on marble.
整座建筑物是用大理石建成。
And it was engraved with different emerald stones.
到处都有绿宝石的雕刻。
All of the women in the palace carried lamps made of valuable jewels.
宫中的女子手中拿着珍贵宝石做成的灯饰。
Yeah, there was no electricity, so they used the jewels to get lights.
因为当时是没有电的，他们便用珍贵的宝石来放射光芒。
The flames and the jewels combined to produce wonderful, brilliant light.
灯饰发出的光芒和宝石的光芒合在一起，就散发出，使屋子分外的明亮。
So when the Brahmana saw his position had suddenly changed to so much opulence, he could not understand the reason.
当这位 Brahmana 看见自己的地位突然之间变得如此富裕，一时不能肯定原因。
And he began to think, why such a sudden change in everything?
他开始深深的思索，为什么突然之间就有这么大的转变呢？
And he thought, how could it have happened?
他心里想，这到底是怎样的一回事呢？
So he began to think, he thought, from the very beginning of my life, I've been very poor.
他想着，我一生下来就很贫穷。
So what could be the cause of so much sudden opulence?
这突如其来的巨大富裕到底是什么原因呢？
Sudama thought, I don't find any reason other than the fact that the all-merciful glance of my friend Lord Krishna.
Sudama 想，除了我的朋友主 Krishna 的恩慈的瞥视外，我再找不出其他原因了。
He's the chief of the Yadu dynasty.
主 Krishna 是亚杜王朝的主人。
So certainly these are all gifts of Lord Krishna's mercy.
这必定是他，是主 Krishna 无缘恩慈的礼物。
Krishna is self-sufficient, and he's the husband of the goddess of fortune.
Krishna 是幸运女神的丈夫，是自给自足的。
So he's always full with all the six opulences.
他总是充盈着六种富裕。
And he can understand the mind of his devotee.
他能明白奉献者的心意。
So he will always fulfill the devotee's desire.
他永远会满足他奉献者的愿望。
So all of these gifts are acts.Of my friend Lord Krishna.
这一切的礼物都是我的朋友 Krishna 所为。
My beautiful dark friend Krishna is far more liberal than the clouds.
我俊英俊黝黑的朋友 Krishna 比云朵还慷慨。
Now, the clouds, they can fill the great ocean with water.
云朵会让海洋满载着雨水。
And Krishna is even more generous than these clouds.
Krishna 却比这些云朵还要慷慨。
So Krishna doesn't like to disturb the farmers with rain during the day.
云朵不会在白天下雨骚扰农夫。
Instead, the clouds bring the rain at night, just to satisfy the farmer.
相反，云朵只是晚上慷慨的下雨来满足农夫。
But when the farmer wakes up in the morning, he thinks that it has not rained enough.
等到农夫第二天早上醒来，还以为没有下过雨呢。
No, it's not rained enough. It rained, but not rained enough.
Oh, sorry. 这农民他醒来之后。就认为这个雨虽然下了雨，但是雨下的还不够充沛。
So Krishna fulfills the desires of everyone according to his position.
Krishna 会按照每个人相应的地位来满足每个人。
But if someone is not in Krishna consciousness, then Krishna considers.All the gifts to be less than what he wants. Now, wait just a minute. If somebody, Krishna fulfills everyone's desires, but for someone who is not Krishna conscious, he considers that Krishna's gifts are not as much as what he wanted.
对于一个不在Krishna知觉中的人，他认为Krishna赐予的礼物并不理想，没有满足他的心愿。
But when Krishna receives a little thing in love and affection from his devotee, he considers it a very great and valuable gift.
而主, Krishna, 只要从奉献者那里得到了少许的充满爱心的礼物，他便觉得这份礼物已经是非常巨大珍贵的。
And Sudama thought, I'm a very clear example of this.
Sudama 心想, 我便是这样一个很清楚的很好的例子。
I only offered him some morsels of chipped rice.
我只 向他供奉了一小把碎米线。
But in return, he has given me opulences greater than the opulence of the King of Heaven.
但是主Krishna却回报我天地还要多的富裕。
So when the devotee actually offers Krishna, what the devotee offers to Krishna, it's not actually needed by Krishna.
奉献者供奉给Krishna的，实际上 Krishna并不需要。
Krishna is self-sufficient. He has everything he needs.
Krishna是自足的，他已经拥有了他一切。
But if the devotee offers something to Krishna, it acts for the devotee's own benefit.
奉献者倘若给Krishna供奉的话，那都是只是有利于他自己的利益。
And whatever a devotee offers Krishna, it comes back in a quantity millions of times greater than what was offered.
无论奉献者供奉了是什么，他都可以得到百万倍数量的回报。
So we should understand, we don't lose anything by giving to Krishna. One becomes a gainer millions of times.
我们要明白，倘若我们给Krishna供奉的话，我们没有损失，相反，我们有百万倍的收益。
So the Brahmana, Sudama, felt so obliged to Krishna.
Sudama Brahmana 感到对Krishna 深深的亏欠Krishna.
And he thought, Sudama thought to himself, I pray to have the friendship of Lord Krishna and to engage in his service.
Sudama 心想, 我祈求能得到主Krishna的友谊，服务他。
And I want to surrender fully unto him in love and affection, life after life.
我想要怀着爱，生生世世的来臣服他。
Sudama thought, I don't want any opulence.
Sudama 心想, 我不希望得到任何富裕。
I only desire that I never forget his service.
我唯一的愿望就是不要忘记对他的服务。
I just want to be associated with his pure devotees.
我一心一意只希望得到他纯粹奉献者的联谊。And
I want that my mind and activities be always engaged in his service.
愿我的心意和活动恒常地从事为他服务。
So the unborn Krishna is the unborn Supreme Personality of Godhead, and he knows that many great personalities have fallen from their position because of too much opulence.
Krishna 是至尊性格神首，他知道许多的伟大人物都因为奢华的富裕而从自己的地位上堕落下来。
So Sudama thought, even when his devotee, even when Krishna's devotees ask for some opulence from Krishna, Krishna sometimes does not give it.
Sudama 心想，所以甚至当他的奉献者向 Krishna 要求一些富裕的时候，主有的时候也不会答允许得他得到这些富裕。
Krishna is very careful about his devotees.
Krishna 对他的奉献者十分的关心小心。
A devotee in an immature position of devotional service may be given great opulence.
在不奉献服务不成熟地位上的奉献者们，也许被提供了许多的富裕。
But due to that opulence, they may fall from his position.
由于这些富裕，他们可能会从自己的地位上堕落下来。
So the Lord does not offer opulence to him. He wants to protect him.
主为了保护这样的奉献者，就不会向他提供富裕。
So this is Krishna's causeless mercy on his devotees.
这是 Krishna 对他奉献者的无缘仁慈。
Krishna's first interest is that the devotee should not fall back into material life.
Krishna 最首要的兴趣就是他的奉献者不要再堕落回物质的生活当中。
So Sudama thought Krishna is just like a well-wishing father.
Sudama 心想 ，Krishna 就像一个充满祝福的父亲。
The father will not give too much money in the hand of his immature son.
父亲就不会给他不成熟的儿子太多的富裕。
But when the father sees that the son is mature and he knows how to spend money carefully, then he will give all of his money to him.
一旦父亲看到儿子已经长大成熟，并且会花钱了，他会把所有钱都给儿子。
So Sudama thought that whatever opulence he's received from Krishna, it should be used not for his sense gratification, but for the service of Krishna.
Sudama 想，无论他从那里获得了什么样的富裕，都应当用于不应该用于自己的感官享乐，而应该用于为主做服务。
So the Brahmana accepted all of this opulence, but he accepted it in a spirit of renunciation.
这位婆罗门便接受了他刚刚获得的富裕，但他却是以一种弃绝的精神接受的。
Sudama remained unattached to sense gratification.
Sudama 仍然保持着不依附感官享乐。
He lived with his wife very peacefully, enjoying all the facilities, all the opulence, as the mercy of Krishna.
他和自己的妻子平和地生活在那里，把这些富裕都当成 Krishna 的仁慈来接受。
He enjoyed all different varieties of food by offering to Krishna.
他 他享受了各，他通过把各种各样的食物供奉给 Krishna 来享受这些食物。
Only after it was offered to Krishna, then he would take the prasadam.
只有当这些食物已经供奉给 Krishna 之后，他才把它们当成 prasadam 来接受。
So if by the grace of Krishna we get some opulence, like material wealth or fame or power, education, beauty, then it's our duty to consider that these are the gifts of Krishna.
同样，倘若急着主的仁慈，我们得到了像物质的财富、名声、力量、教育、美貌这样的富裕，我们就有职责来把这些都视为来自主的礼物。
Nothing is for our sense gratification.
没有一样应该，来被利用，被用于我们自己的感官享乐。
So Sudama stayed in that position. He kept that consciousness, and so his love and devotion for Krishna increased day after day.
Sudama 便保持这样的知觉和这样的地位。他对主 Krishna 的爱和深情日益的增长着。
Although he was surrounded by opulence, he didn't lose his devotion.
尽管他被物质的富裕所环绕，他并没有失去自己的奉爱之心。
Material opulence can be the cause of degradation.
物质富裕可以成为堕落的根源。
But material opulence can also be the cause of elevation.
而物质富裕也可以成为一个人提升的原因。
It depends on the purpose, how we use the opulence.
它取决于我们如何来使用这些富裕。
When the opulence is used for sense gratification, then we fall down.
当富裕被用于自己的感官享乐，我们就会堕落。
But if we use the opulence in the service of Krishna, it's the cause of elevation.
如果富裕被用来为 Krishna 做服务，就会成为我们提升的原因。
So we see from Lord Krishna's dealings with Sudama Vipra that Krishna is very, very pleased with a person.Who possesses brahminical qualities?
从主 Krishna 和 Sudama Brahmana 的交往当中，我们可以看到 Krishna 对于拥有婆罗门品质的人非常非常满意。
A qualified Brahmana like Sudama Vipra is naturally a devotee of Krishna.
像 Sudama Vipra 这样的合格婆罗门。自然而然的是主 Krishna 的奉献者。
So it is said that Brahmana Vaishnava, a Brahmana is a Vaishnava.
因此有这样的说法，一位婆罗门是一位 Vaishnava.
Sometimes it is said Brahmana Pandita, which means Pandit means very learned person.
或者有的时候据说。Brahmana Pandita, Pandita 意思是一个有高度学识的人。
So a Brahmana cannot be foolish or uneducated.
因为婆罗门不能是愚蠢的，或者是没有受过教育的。
So there are two kinds of Brahmanas. One is the Vaishnava Brahmana, and the other is the Pandita Brahmana.
因此有两类 Brahmana, 一类是 Vaishnava.Brahmana, 一类是 Pandita Brahmana.
So, some people are that they may be learned, they may be pandits, but they're not. They may not be devotees.
有些人尽管很博学，是 Pandita, 但他们不是主的奉献者。
So Lord Krishna is not very much pleased with them.
主 Krishna 对这样的人并不十分满意。
So the qualification of being a learned Brahmana is not enough to attract Krishna.
成为一位婆罗婆婆婆罗门的，仅仅是婆罗门的资格，并不足以吸引 Krishna。
So not only must a Brahmana be well qualified according to the requirements in the scriptures. A Brahmana must be qualified according to the scriptures.
一位婆罗门必须是根据经典的要求具备资格。
Qualifications are given in the Bhagavad Gita and in Srimad Bhagavatam.
他们的资格在《博伽梵歌》和《博伽瓦坛》当中被提及。
But that's not the only qualification for a Brahmana.
但这不是 Brahmana 的唯一资格。
He must also be a devotee of Lord Krishna.
他必须同时是主 Krishna 的奉献者。
So the example of Sudama Brahmana is very clear.
Sudama Brahmana 的榜样是非常清楚的。
He was a qualified Brahmana. He was unattached to the material sense gratification.
他是一位合格的 Brahmana, 他不依附于任何的物质感官享乐。
At the same time, he was a great devotee of Lord Krishna.
同时他还是主 Krishna 的伟大奉献者。
Lord Krishna,is the enjoyer of all sacrifices and penances.
Lord Krishna 是一切祭祀苦行的享受者。
And he's very, very fond. He likes very much brahmanas like Sudama Vipra.
他非常钟爱像 Sudama Vipra 这样婆罗门。
Lord Krishna showed by his behavior how much he loves brahmanas like Sudama.
主 Krishna 通过自己的行为举止表明他多么钟爱像 Sudama Vipra 这样的婆罗门。
So the ideal stage of human perfection is to become a Brahmana Vaishnava like Sudama Vipra.
人类完美的理想阶段就是成为像 Sudama Vipra 这样的 Brahmana Vaishnava.
Sudama realized.That although Lord Krishna is unconquerable, he agrees to be conquered by his devotees.
Sudama 意识到，尽管主 Krishna 是不可被征服的，但他仍然同意被奉献者所征服。
And Sudama understood how kind Lord Krishna was to him.
Sudama 也意识到主 Krishna 对他是多么仁慈。
So because of this, Sudama was always in trance, constantly thinking of Krishna.
所以 Sudama 总是在神定当中恒常地想着 Krishna.
So by the constant association with Krishna, always whatever darkness,of material contamination was in the heart was completely removed.
通过这样恒常的和主 Krishna 的联谊，在他内心当中仍然存留的无论有什么样的物质污染的黑暗都被彻底的清除掉了。
And very shortly, Sudama was transferred to the spiritual kingdom.Which is the goal of all saintly persons in the perfectional stage of life.
在很短的时间内 ，Sudama Brahmana 就被转移到了灵性的王国，而灵性的王国是所有在人生完美阶段的圣人们的目标。
So Sukadeva Goswami was telling this story about Sudama Brahman. He was telling it to Maharaj Parikshit.
Sukadeva Goswami 向 Maharaj Parikshit 讲述了 Sudama Brahman 的故事。
So he said that whoever hears this history about Sudama Vipra and Lord Krishna they will know how much love Lord Krishna has for the Brahmana devotees like Sudama.
他说，任何聆听了这段历史的人，他便知道了，主 Krishna 对于像 Sudama Brahmana 这样的婆罗门是多么的钟爱。
So anyone who hears this history gradually becomes as qualified as Sudama Vipra.
任何人倘若聆听了这段历史，便逐渐的会有资格。像 Sudama Vipra 那样的有资格。
And in the same way, they will be transferred to the spiritual kingdom of Lord Krishna.
以同样的方式，他将会被转移到主 Krishna 的灵性王国。
So this is the end of the story. Sudama Krishna, benedicted by Lord Krishna. Brahmana Sudama, blessed by Lord Krishna.
就此结束了，Brahmana Sudama Brahmana 被主 Krishna 赐福的历史。
So we can begin chapter 82, Krishna and Balaram meet the Brijabasis.
我们接着就讲第八十二章，主 Krishna 与 Balaram。
So it said, once upon a time, Lord Krishna and Balaram were living peacefully in the great city of Dwarka.
有一回，主 Krishna 和 Balarama 正在 Dwarka 城过着宁静的生活。
But at that time, then there was the rare occasion of a full solar eclipse.
那里出现了罕见的日全食。
So this usually takes place. Usually, it only takes place at the end of every kalpa or the end of every day of Brahma. So it's very special.
这通常是在每一个 kalpa 或者是 Brahma 一天之末才可以看到。
So at the end of every kalpa, the sun is covered by a great cloud.
在每一个 kalpa, 每一劫难之末，太阳被巨大的云朵所遮蔽。
And then heavy rain covers the lower planetary systems.
有暴雨便覆盖了低等的星系。
All the way up, covers all the planets all the way up to Swargaloka, which is the heavenly planets.
这个暴雨会一直把低等的星系一直到 Swargaloka, 也就是天堂都覆盖了。
So, at 5,000 years ago, there were learned brahmanas who knew the astronomical science.And they knew that this eclipse was going to take place.
在五千年前，有精通星象计算的星象师，他们知道，这件事将会发生。
So they knew before the event took place, and therefore men and women, they decided to go to a holy place, like.Kurukshetra to perform some religious rituals.
因为他们提前便预知了这个日食，所以每一个人，包括男人和女人，便决定在Kurukshetra 这个圣地聚集在那里来举行宗教仪式。
So, at Kurukshetra.There's a place called Samanta Panchak.
在 Kurukshetra 这地方有一个圣地名叫 Samanta Panchak.
So it was in this place Lord Parasuram had performed great sacrifices.
主 Parashurama 曾经在这个地方举行巨大的献祭。
Lord Parashurama had killed the Kshatriyas 21 times, killed all the Kshatriyas 21 times. So after killing them all, then he came there to perform a great sacrifice.
主 Parashurama 杀死了所有的刹帝利21次。在这之后 Parashurama 便来到这个地方来做祭祀。
When Lord Parashurama killed all the Kshatriyas, there was so much blood, it flowed like a river.
当主 Parashurama 杀死所有的刹帝利之后，这些刹帝利的鲜血就像河流一样流动着。
So Lord Parashurama, he dug five big lakes, and each of the five lakes was filled with the blood.
主 Parashurama 便挖掘了五口大湖，每一口湖泊都充满着这些鲜血。
So Lord Parashurama, he is Vishnu Tattva, he's not an ordinary person.
主 Parashurama 是属于 Vishnu Tattva, 他不是普通人。
So because he's Vishnu Tattva, it's described in the Ishopanishad that Vishnu Tattva.People cannot be contaminated by any sinful activity.
在至尊奥义书当中便说到 Vishnu Tattva 不会被任何罪恶活动所污染。
But although Lord Parashurama is very powerful and uncontaminated, but he wanted to show the right example to others, so he performed a great sacrifice.
尽管主 Parashurama 是全然有力量不受污染的，但为了给世人做榜样，他便举行了巨大的献祭。
So he did the sacrifice at the Samanta Panchak, and the purpose was to atone for his killing so many people.
他在 Samanta Panchak 这个地方举行巨大的祭祀。目的就是为了杀死这些沙锤啊，来忏悔赎罪。
So by the example of Lord Parashurama, he showed that killing sometimes may be necessary, but it is not good.
通过他的榜样表率，主 Parashurama 便展示出，尽管杀戮是必要的，但却并不是件好事。
So Lord Parashurama thought that he was responsible for the killing of so many people. So he must do something to atone for that.
主 Parashurama 便认为他自己要为杀死这么多的人而负责，所以他应该为此而赎罪。
Lord Parashurama is.Vishnu Tattva, he's the Supreme Lord. So he's not responsible, he doesn't get sinful reactions. But we do.
Parashurama, 他是至尊主，他不会招致罪恶反应，但是我们却会因此而招致罪恶反应。
We get reactions if we kill people, then we get very severe.Reactions.
如果我们杀了人，会因此而得到非常严重的罪恶反应。
So we see all over the world, since the beginning of time, it's been condemned. People have been condemned. People it's been prohibited to kill people.
所以我们看到，在全世界从不可追忆的时候起。便禁止杀死去杀戮其他人。
So taking advantage of the solar eclipse, all the important people from all parts of Bharatvarsh, they all visited the holy place of pilgrimage.
来自 Bharatvarsh, 各个地方的 人们便利用了日食的机会来拜访朝圣之地。
So some of the important people, their names are mentioned. Among the elderly people, there were people like Akrura and Vasudev and Ugrasena.
下面便提到了来朝圣的这些重要人物的名字，在一些长者当中有 Akrura、Vasudeva 和 Ugrasena。
And among the younger people were people like Gadha and Pradyumna and Samba。
而在年轻一代人当中呢，有 Gadha、Pradyumna、Samba。
And there were many other members of the Yadu dynasty who had come there to make up, to do atonement for their sinful activities。
还有来自亚度王朝的其他成员，他们也来到这处圣地来为罪恶活动来忏悔赎罪。
Because in the course of doing different duties, we will sometimes do things wrong, we'll do sinful things. So we want to atone for that.
因为在履行各自的职责的过程当中，我们可能会出错、犯错，因此要为此而赎罪。
So almost all the members of the Yadu dynasty went to Kurukshetra.
几乎所有全体亚度王朝成员都去了 Kurukshetra。
People like Aniruddha and the son of Pradyumna. Aniruddha, of course, he's the son of Pradyumna.
包括 Pradyumna 的儿子 Aniruddha。
And Kritavarma also came. He was the commander of the Yadu army.
亚度军队的统帅 Kritavarma 也去了。
And along with him came people like Suchandra and Shuka and Sharana.
陪同着他的还有 Suchandra, Shuka, Sharana.
They stayed in Dwarka to protect the city.
他们留在了 Dwarka 来保护 Dwarka。
So Kritavarma, he was the commander, and he stayed along with other people like Suchandra, Sukha, and Sarna. They stayed in Dwarka to protect the city.
Kritavarma 是统帅，他和其余的这三个人留在 Dwarka 来保护 Dwarka.
All right, so we'll stop here, and we'll ask if there's any questions.
好，我们就停在这里，接下来。请问有没有问题？有啊 ，Tisachi 对大师 raised her hand。Padamukhi 马拉吉，看见举手的了吗？
啊哈，Hare Krishna。Yes, hi, it's okay now. Hare Krishna, dear Guru Maharaj, visited my humble businesses, all Gurus to Srila Prabhupada, Guru Dev.My question is about Brahman Sudama. Why did Rukmini Devi, stop Krishna from eating the rice he received from the Brahman Sudama? And what was wrong with Sudama becoming even richer?
What was wrong with Sudama?
What was wrong with Sudama becoming even richer?
对不，布鲁玛尼，你重新开一下麦。
哦，好的。第一个问题是，
告诉咕噜也重新开一下麦，我刚才把全体的麦都解一下。
Maharaj, please unmute yourself.
Okay. Yeah.
Yuvati Sachi, the.
I heard the question.
Understand.
Yeah.
第一个问题是，就是为什么幸女神不让主 Krishna 吃更多的碎米屑
？Well.First of all, the rice which Sudama brought, the rice which Sudama brought was very poor quality. It was broken chips of rice. It was dried rice. It was not the best thing to offer to Lord Krishna.
Because Sudama Brahmana, he brought these rice balls.质量也不好，而且都碎了，所以不适合供奉给主 Krishna。
And also the goddess of fortune considered that Lord Krishna, by accepting even that little piece morsel of rice, is going to repay every, is going to give everything to Sudama。
而且幸运女神她认为，哪怕 Krishna 只是吃了一点点这些碎米屑，就足以。
Sudama had nothing, but somehow he managed to get some rice from somebody else. So Sudama gave everything he had, and more.
Sudama, he 本来是一贫如洗的，但是他设法从别人那里得到了一些碎米屑。所以呢，对他来说，他已经献给把一切都献给 Krishna， 而且他已经超过了他能力范围了。
So because Sudama gave everything, Lord Krishna has to give. He should reciprocate by giving everything back, by giving everything he has back to Sudama.
由于 Sudama 的这个行为呢，就使得 Krishna 呢要回报他。把他的所拥有的一切也给苏达曼布拉曼。
So he couldn't give any more opulence than what he gave. He gave everything as it was.
他 gave
Sudama everything he possesses.
主 Krishna 就把他所拥有的一切都给了 Sudama。
He reciprocated. Sudama gave more than Sudama. You have to understand also. Sudama didn't like opulences. He actually didn't like opulences, but Krishna forced him to accept opulence.
Sudama 呢，他本来是不喜欢富裕物质的富裕，但是 Krishna 就是强迫他接受了这一切富裕。
OK。
第二个问题，第二部分的问题是，已经回答了吗？
Yeah, 回答了。
哦，回答了 ，OK。下一个问题是来自于维慧，顶拜咕噜，我有个问题：圣典波迦瓦坛发生在几千年前，是真实发生的事情吗？是历史吗？宇宙古史都属于真实发生的历史是吗？五千年前 ，Krishna 显现在文达文。也属于真实发生的历史事吗？不是故事是吧？
不是故事，是真实的。明白吗？
是真。
Yes, you can go to Vrindavan, you can see all the places where Krishna performed these pastimes. All of these things happened 5,000 years ago.You can go to Kurukshetra, You can see the place where Krishna performed the sacrifice. You can see also the place where grandfather Bhishma gave up his body. You can see the place where the battle of Kurukshetra was fought. It's all history. It's history, it's not just stories.
就您可以去文达文去看到Krishna五千年前在那里上演消失光的地点，你也可以亲自就去库枝野，去那里看见到Krishna在那里举行祭祀的地方，也可以去看Bhishma放弃躯体的地方，也可以去看库卢战役，就是库枝野战役打仗的那个地方。 这些都是真实的，不是历史，这些是历史，不是故事。If
you know astronomy, you can calculate the planets, and you can see 5,000 years ago there was a full eclipse of the sun.
如果您懂一些占星的话，知道这个可以计算这个星象，你就知道在5000年前发生过一次日食。
And it was at that time Lord Krishna went there to Kurukshetra.
就是在这次日食发生的期间，主 Krishna 去了库枝野。We're
not just telling stories; these are real things, real events which took place 5,000 years ago.
我们在这里并没有讲故事。 我们只是在叙述5000年前发生的历史。OK。啊，雄猪化身，你身上半人半狮的化身，化身也是真实显现的，是吧？那些奉献者的名字都是真实的，是吧？ Varaha Avatar, 你身上。 Avatar, they are all true, and all, the names of the devotee are all true, authentic?
Yes, they're all true.
都是真实的.
In the past, before the Kali Yuga, people would hear everything. There was no need to write things down. But with Kali Yuga, people have very poor memories, so they began writing things down.
在卡利年代之前的年代呢，人们记忆力非常好，他们就只要听靠听力，他们就可以记住了，他们不需要来写字。但是到卡利年代的时候呢，人们的记忆力特别差，所以他们需要来。 用笔记下来，用文字的形式记载下来。Okay. That's all question. All question.
No more questions.
现在呢？现在没有。 Only this question.
Thai, well, did Thai devotees come in? Did you see any?
Oh, yeah. Yuvati Sachis has already raised the question.
Again.
请问就咱们房间里泰国奉献者有没有问题? Are there any questions?
Hare Krishna, I have one more question. Guru Mani Mataji.
Yes.
Guru Maharaj, why did Sudama Brahman have to go to Vaikuntha and not to go to Goloka Vrindavana? Because he was in Sankhya Rasa.
问题是为什么 Sudama Brahman 去了Vaikuntha而没有去 Goloka? 是不是他是 Sankhya Rasa 就是朋友的关系？
Because his Leela was with Krishna in Dwarka, he was not with Krishna in Vrindavan. He never met Krishna in Vrindavan.
Mm-hmm.
因为他的消，他和主 Krishna 的消时光都是发生在 Dwarka， 他没有在 Vrindavan 遇见 Krishna。
So in Vaikuntha, oh, the predominant mood is Dasharas, but there's also some tinge of friendship also there. Just like Urva is also there in Dwarka.
Because in
You know, it's the spiritual world, you know. Vaikuntha is also the spiritual world. Don't minimize him just because he doesn't go to Vrindavan.
Vaikuntha is also the spiritual world. Don't minimize him just because
You cannot force yourself into Vrindavan.
不能，强迫自己一定要去 Vrindavan.
Can also serve Krishna very nicely in Vaikuntha.
在 Vaikuntha.也可以很好的服务 Krishna.
They are also pure devotees.
在 Vaikuntha 的也都是纯粹的奉献者。
Okay.
Thank you very much, Guru Maharaj. Hare Krishna.
All right, so thank you, Guru Mani, for the translation.
Thank you, Maharaj.For your wonderful lecture.
So we'll stop here tonight. All glory Srila Prabhupada. One hand.
Jai.